Now, believe me, on the surface, this doesn't look like the most interesting kind of thing. I understand that, and I agree with that. But after doing more research into actually who this guy is, I think the Anaheim Ducks have just signed the most interesting free agent in the NHL. This season, at least. Or at least in the past little while. Earlier today, the Anaheim Ducks signed a defenseman out of Sweden. His name is Kodie Curran, and he is 30 years old. Now, he's a left-handed D-man getting... let's just face it, it's his first NHL contract ever. And the Anaheim Ducks signed this guy to a one-way contract for 2 years at $1 million. So, there's gotta be a story here, right? It's difficult to find scenarios where teams sign 30-year-old men who have never played in the NHL before to contracts like this. And Anaheim Ducks fans were even more dumbfounded when they realized, what the heck, he's a left-handed D. We don't need any more of those. Sure, Michael Delzato was going to be gone in free agency, but what about everybody else? Lindholm, Fowler, Juice, Gouley, Larson. You got Benoit too? What's the point of signing another left-handed D, an unproven one at that, to a one-way contract for 2 years? Now that's something that I've seen everywhere, but this guy, Kodie Curran, honestly, I think there's got to be a little bit more respect to his name. This is a guy who has had probably the weirdest story coming into the NHL that we've seen in a very long time. Kodie Curran is a left-handed defenseman from Alberta. He was born in 1989, and he played his earliest recorded hockey games on Elite Prospects in the AJHL for the Calgary Canucks. Yes, there is indeed an AJHL team by the name of the Calgary Canucks. This is junior A hockey in Alberta, and he played his draft year for the Calgary Canucks, getting 39 points in 55 games as a defenseman. Now, those numbers aren't amazing, especially compared to other U19, U18 defensemen who have played in the AJHL in the past. Cale Makar, obviously the best one. Michael Benning is a guy that we talked about who's eligible for the 2020 NHL draft. Jim Benning's nephew, and a guy who was very good point production-wise. But on this list of U19 AJHL defenders from 2000-2001 up until now, Kodie Curran's draft year lists 30th, so it's not really super surprising to me that this guy was not drafted. He spent another year in the AJHL after that. He was a pretty good D-man, just over a point per game. But then, he decided to go to college. And in fact, he played 5 full years at the University of Calgary in the U-SPORTS program. Now, this is interesting, because the U-SPORTS hockey program absolutely is not the same as the NCAA's hockey program, where they have guys going into college, playing a few years, maybe graduating, and then going pro, either AHL or NHL. The U-SPORTS Hockey League in Canada, with UBC, University of Calgary, all these other Canadian universities, is that compared to NCAA hockey, it's not that great. There's only really like 2 players who played U-SPORTS and ended up actually becoming NHL players, and the best one is Joel Ward. You may remember Darryl Boyce when he played with the Leafs. He's a guy who also was from U-SPORTS, but in general, this is a comment here from Reddit, Canadian inter-university sports schools don't support free-ride scholarships based on athletics like the NCAA schools can. So they can't just bring in really good hockey players because they're good at hockey, give them an education, and allow them to bolster their hockey teams. Instead, U-Sports teams are comprised of students who get in because they're studying. Not because they're playing hockey, but because they're literally out there trying to get degrees. And that's why Kodie Curran spent a full 5 years at the University of Calgary before signing an AHL deal to play with the Hartford Wolfpack and eventually the Greenville Swamp Rabbits in the ECHL, where he was somewhat successful over there. And after finishing up his career at the U-Sports level, he was 25. This guy is supposed to be in his quote-unquote prime, as NHL monitoring people would say. But the jump from U-Sports to NHL is considered as such a big jump. In fact, the jump from U-Sports to NCAA is considered a big jump in itself, that this guy over here, who was okay at the AJHL level, who was good enough to play on a U-Sports team and not do terribly, was just another guy. And it looked like that for a long time. In fact, there was nothing really setting this guy apart on the radar. But then he went to Denmark. 33 points in 45 games for the Esbjerg Energy, which is pretty good. It's pro hockey, it's in Europe, so it's not the same as the NHL, but hey, he just spent a full year in Denmark playing hockey and getting paid while doing it, so that's great. The next year after that, he goes to Norway, and he captains the Storhamar team. He gets 44 points in 38 games. He's over a point per game. He's a defenseman. At this point, he's 28 years old. And he just wrapped up being the best player in Norway. He was the player of the year. He was the playoffs MVP. He was on the All-Star team. And he also had all these same awards for the Danish League. And then he goes to the SHL. Plays for the Rögle BK, a team that I've seen very dearly because Niels Höglander is over there, and I love him dearly as an NHL prospect. And this guy is an absolute stick of dynamite. The guy moves really nicely, he passes so crisply, he's got a really, really powerful and accurate shot and one-timer ability that, all of a sudden, wrapping up things up in 2019-20, he's over a point per game. He's a left-handed D-man in the SHL, getting 49 points in 48 games. Check this out. The guy was the second highest point producer in the entire league. Think about that. He was so good that he had the most points by a defenseman. Obviously, he had the second most points in the league. He was the D-man of the year and the MVP of the league. He pretty much won the Hart Trophy over there in the SHL. And for some reason, this guy is just finding ways to get better and better and better without slowing down, even though he's now 30. So much to the point that now the next step looks to be the NHL. And I say the NHL because the guy signed a one-way contract. If you sign a one-way contract, it doesn't mean that you're only allowed to play in the NHL, it just means that you get paid the same amount of money, whether you're playing the NHL or the AHL or not. But getting signed to a one-way contract, to me, indicates that the Anaheim Ducks have the ability and the willingness to at least try it. And we said that there's a logjam of left-handed D in Anaheim, but if you have an opportunity to sign the guy who was probably one of the best players in Sweden this past season, then I don't see why there's a risk there in trying to pick him up. And his story is just so weird and so unique that I just thought I really needed to talk about this here. From the AJHL as a teenager, being okay, to the U-Sports, a full 5 years of U-Sports, and then going over into a brief stint in the ECHL, going over to Europe, and finally finding his game at 27, 28, 29, and 30 years old, Kodie Curran's time to shine is now. Well, not now, I mean it'll be in like a few months from now once the NHL starts back up again. We don't know if that's going to be until January. Those were the rumors floating around. The Anaheim Ducks are a bad team. They're not in the play-in rounds, so they're not going to have an opportunity to use this player, but he is under contract for the next 2 years on a one-way deal for $1 million, and he has never had an NHL contract before. This is a guy who has just carved himself a path after years and years and years of hard work, and I love it. This is a great player for the Rögle BK. Watching the Niels Höglander footage, this guy always stood out. He is crazy good as a power play offensive defenseman, and if the Anaheim Ducks want to capitalize on that, my goodness, if they do, and if this translates, which it might not, we really can't predict these things, then the Anaheim Ducks could potentially have just gotten themselves a really nice pickup. So comment down below what you think about Kodie Curran and his weird, weird, weird story from the Calgary Canucks to Europe to the Anaheim Ducks. Comment down below what you think. I hope you enjoyed this video. So that's Trollist99. And bye.